Hi, it's nice to meet you again. If you remember in the previous video, I did mention about the definition of bearing capacity and shear load foundation. In addition to that, I gave you an example of a shear load foundation whereby we use the Zagis equation to solve the problem. In that example, we are given a footing with specific dimension, and then we have to determine the load that can be carried by the foundation. This time, I want to show you one example whereby we have to design the foundation for a given load. Before we work on the given example, I would suggest that you write down or you draw first the diagram of the shear load foundation here and the problem statement. In the previous video or in the previous example, we used the Zagis equation. Right? So in this case, we have a footing with unknown dimension B multiplied by B with a known depth of footing 2 meters. And these are the swallow properties, 18 kN per meter cube, that is the unit weight. The internal friction angle of the soil is 30 degrees. Cohesion C is equal to 0. So when C equal to 0, it shows that the soil here is cohesionless soil, like sand or gravel. Okay. If you look at this diagram, you see there's a load here. Shown as the Q allowable equal to 2000 kN inclined at an angle 80 degrees with respect to the horizontal. So the problem here that we have to determine the minimum dimension B if safety factor equal to 2.0. Right. In the Zagis equation, we assume that the applied loads are vertical. The Zagis equations don't take into account the inclination of load. Therefore, we have to use different equation to solve this problem. The equation that we want to use is known as Meyerhoff-Hansen's general equation for bearing capacity. Right? So, the equation, the Meyerhoff-Hansen equation is Q sub U, again, represents the ultimate bearing capacity equals to C multiplied by N sub C multiplied by FCS multiplied by FCD multiplied by FCI plus Q multiplied by N sub Q multiplied by FQ sub S multiplied by FQ sub D multiplied by FQ sub I plus 1/2 gamma D M gamma F gamma S F gamma D F gamma I. Unlike the Zagis equation, Meyerhoff-Hansen's equation, this equation has additional bearing capacity factors. Right? In the Zagis equation, we have C and C, Q and Q, gamma B and gamma. So the additional factors that we have to consider in Meyerhoff-Hansen's equations are FCS, FCD, FCI. So if you notice the Fs, for the C term here, the subscript for F start with C. So for C term, C and C, F, C, F, C, F, C. But the second subscript for the Fs, S, D, and I. Similarly, with Q term, Q multiplied by N sub Q, and then we have additional factors, F, FQS, FQD, FQI. So for the group of Q term, the subscript for the Fs start with Q, meaning in the group of Q term, the second subscript are S, D, I. Similar to in the C term, the second subscript S, D, I, here also S, D, I. Plus 1 half gamma B N gamma, F gamma S, F gamma D, F gamma I. So again, the subscript for the Fs in the gamma term here start with gamma, 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 and the second subscript S, D, I. Alright, so for this equation, right? C term, C N C, F C S, F C D, F C I. Q term, Q N Q, F Q S, F Q D, F Q I. The gamma term, 1 half gamma B N gamma, F gamma S, F gamma D, F gamma I. Right. NC, NQ, and N gamma, you can refer to the table. If you use this book, you can refer to page 60 to obtain the values of N sub C, N sub Q, and N sub gamma. Okay? Don't forget to refer the table, should be Meyerhoff-Hansen's table, not Terzaghi's table. Okay. Right. In addition to that, what CS, CD, CI, QS, QD, QI, gamma S, gamma D, gamma I mean? Okay? So for the C term here, C, 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 we have again SDI, in Q term also SDI, in gamma term also SDI. So for the subscript S, CS, QS, gamma S, those represent factor, what we call shape factors. So S, S, S represents shape. Okay? For the term of FCD, FQD, F gamma D, the term D, D, and D represent depth factors. Okay? Finally, for the I subscript for FCI, FQI, F gamma I represent inclination of the load. So in this case, the load is inclined. So we have to determine the inclination factor. Right. So those factors, right, shape factors, depth factors, inclination factors, if you use this book, you have to refer to page 23 and 24 because there are equations to determine those factors. If we refer to the ultimate bearing capacity equation using Meyerhoff-Hansen's equation, right, and then if we refer to the swell parameters, we could see C equal to 0. So in that case, C term cancel out. So we don't have to determine or we don't have to calculate the C terms, right? So we move on to obtain the soil parameters, bearing capacities, not the soil parameters, but the bearing capacity factors based on the friction angle, right? So for friction angle equal to 30 degrees, for friction angle equal to 33 degrees, right? If you refer to the table, right, N sub Q is equal to 26.12, and then N gamma is equal to 35.24. Right? So we don't have to obtain the value of n sub c, because c terms cancel out because c equal to 0. Okay? Now, let's move on to shape factors. Okay? Shape factors. What are the shape factors? Right? So for the c term, we don't have to calculate. So we straightaway go to the q term, which is fqs. For q term, shape factor fqs. If you refer to page 23 in the yellow book or in other geotechnical engineering book, you can find that fqs is given as 1 plus d over l tangent phi. Okay, so in this problem, the foundation is square, meaning b over l is equal to 1, right? Square footing, so b is equal to l, or b over l is equal to 1, right? So we rewrite this equation, 1 plus b over b tangent 33 degrees. So we get value of 1.649. Okay, shape factor for the Q term. Shape factor for the gamma term, F gamma S, given as 1 minus 0.4b over L. Again, it's a square footing, 1 minus 0.4 b divided by b. So we get 0.6. Okay, now let's calculate the depth factors. Okay, depth factors. Depth factors that we have to calculate are FQD and F gamma D. FCD we don't have to calculate because, as I mentioned previously, C equals to 0, so it cancel out. Right. In order to calculate depth factors, there are two conditions that we have to consider. The first condition is df over b less than or equal to 1. The ratio of df, depth of footing, divided by the width of footing, less than or equals to 1. Another condition that we have to consider is when the ratio of depth of footing to the width of footing greater than 1. Right? So df is known, which is 2 meters. But b is unknown. B is the parameter that we have to determine. So in this case, we don't know which case that we have to refer to, because different conditions, we have to use different equation to determine the depth factors. So since we don't know which condition that we have to refer to, then we have to try. After we try, we calculate until the end, then we check again. If it's not correct, then we have to recalculate. Okay, let's say we try, because we don't know which one. Let's try ratio of df over b less than or equal to 1. Right, for the case of df over b less than 1, so FQD, that factor for Q term, is given as 1 plus 2 tangent phi multiplied by 1 minus sine phi. So I think I have to erase this. Square multiplied by df over b. So 1 plus 2 tangent 33 degrees multiplied by 1 minus sine 33 degrees squared right? And DF is 2, B is unknown, so we leave it as B. So solve this equation. It becomes 1 plus 0.539 divided by B. So this equation is expressed as 1 plus 0.539 divided by B. B is still unknown. So still in that factors for F gamma D is equal to 1. F gamma D is equal to 1. Okay, now we calculate the inclination factors. Okay. Inclination factors. So to determine the inclination factors, the equation FQI equals to 1 minus B divided by 90 degrees squared. Sorry, FQI equal to 1 minus beta divided by 90 degrees squared. So what is beta here? Beta here is the angle of inclination with respect to vertical axis. So in our diagram, the load is inclined at 80 degrees with respect to horizontal. So in other words, the load is inclined at 10 degrees with respect to vertical. So in that case, beta is equal to 10 degrees. So you calculate beta 10 degrees divided by 90 degrees squared. So it yields 0.79. Whereby for F gamma I, F gamma I is equal to 1 minus beta divided by friction angle of the soil squared, equal to 1 minus beta is 10 degrees, and friction angle, if you refer to the diagram, friction angle of the soil equals to 33 degrees squared. So F gamma I equals to 0.486. So for now, we have obtained the values of N sub Q and sub gamma, shape factors, depth factors, and inclination factors. So after obtaining those values, now let's insert those values into the ultimate bearing capacity. Okay, we rewrite the ultimate bearing capacity equation. Okay, this is the ultimate bearing capacity equation. So since C is equal to 0, so this equal to 0, right? So it means Q, N, Q, F, Q, S, F, Q, D, F, Q, I, plus 1 half gamma B, and gamma F, gamma S, F, gamma D, F, gamma I. So let's insert the values into this equation, right? Q here is the stress at the base of the footing due to the weight of the soil above the base of the footing, meaning we have to calculate the stress from the ground surface to the base of the footing. So in this case, it's the unit weight of the soil multiplied by the depth of the footing. The unit weight of the soil is 18, and then the depth of footing is 2 meters. So Q here is gamma multiplied by DF. Gamma multiplied by DF, right? N sub Q equal to 26.12 FQS, the shape factor equal to 1.649. Depth factor FQD equals to 1 plus 0.539 divided by B. Right? Still in B term here. Multiply by 0.79. So this one is Q and sub Q, FQS, FQD, FQI. Plus 1/2, gamma is the unit weight of the soil, 18, B unknown, N gamma equals to 35.24, F gamma S equal to 0.6, F gamma D equal to 1, F gamma I equal to 0.486. So now this equation becomes 1224.96 plus 660.26 divided by B plus 92.48 multiplied by B. This is the final equation of this ultimate bearing capacity. Now let's move on to determine the allowable bearing capacity, because in the given problem, the load is allowable load, Q allowable. So that's why after we calculate the ultimate bearing capacity, we have to determine the allowable bearing capacity, which is QALL, small QALL, equals to Q sub U divided by safety factor. Right. The Q sub U here, the Q sub U divided by safety factor equals to 2, so becomes 1 over 2, 2 is the safety factor, so multiply by the ultimate bearing capacity, 1224.96 plus 660.26 divided by B plus 92.48 multiplied by B, yeah, equals to 612.48 plus 330.13 divided by B plus 46.24 B. So the allowable bearing capacity still in the form of unknown B. So after we have calculated the allowable bearing capacity, small q sub ALL or small q sub all, we have to equate the given allowable load, capital Q allowable equal to 2000, should be equals to the allowable bearing capacity multiplied by the area of the footing. Right? So Q allowable should be equal to Q allowable multiplied by the area of the footing. So Q allowable is given in the problem, which equals to 2000 kilonewton, right? And then this 2000 kilonewton should be equal to the Q allowable or the allowable bearing capacity, which is 612 B, this is the allowable bearing capacity, so we have to multiply by area of footing unknown, which is B squared, because it's square footing, right? So this equation becomes 612.48 B squared plus 330.13 B plus 46.24 B cubed. Right? So 2000 equal to 612.48 B squared plus 330.13 B plus 46.24 B cubed. So solve for B. So using your calculator now, you should get this value B about 1.5 meters. Okay, B equal to 1.5 meters. But this is not the final answer yet. We have to check, because if you remember when we in the process of calculating or determining the depth factors, we try the condition of df over b less than or equal to 1. Let's check. So check df over b. So df is 2 meters, okay? 2 meters, the depth of footing, and then the b that we obtain from our calculation equals to 1.5 meter, right? So 2 divided by 1.5 is greater than 1, meaning our previous assumption is not correct, not okay, because try df over b less than equal to 1. Okay, the first assumption, we try df over b less than 1. So then you get b 1.5, and then we check it's greater than 1. So it's not okay. We have to recalculate the depth factors, and then we calculate again the ultimate bearing capacity, and then try to solve the minimum dimension b. Since our assumption based on df over b less than or equals to 1 to determine the depth factors was not correct, then we have to recalculate the depth factors based on the condition of df over b greater than 1. So recalculate depth factor, in this case, based on df over b greater than 1. So in this case, the equation to be used to determine the FQD is slightly different from the equation that we use when df over b less than or equal to 1. So FQD, based on this condition, df over b greater than 1, is given as 1 plus 2 tangent phi multiplied by 1 minus sine phi squared multiplied by inverse tangent df over b. So here we have inverse tangent df over b. Please take note that here must be expressed in radian. Okay, so set your calculator later on in order to get this value in terms of radian. Right. So it becomes 1 plus 2 tangent 33 degrees minus, multiply by 1 minus sine 33 degrees squared inverse tangent df is 2b still unknown. Right? So becomes 1 plus 0.269 multiplied by inverse tangent 2 over b. Like in the previous case, f gamma d is equal to 1. No equation for f gamma d. F gamma d is that way equals to 1. Right. Now let's insert the values into the ultimate bearing capacity equation. So shape factors, inclination factors, we don't have to recalculate. We only recalculate depth factors because we have two conditions that we have to consider. Okay, let's rewrite the ultimate bearing capacity equation here. Qu equal to, and then include the C term because it's equal to 0. So Q sub U equal to Q and Q FUS FUD FUI plus 1 half gamma B and gamma F gamma S F gamma D F gamma I. So as in the previous case, this Q equals to the stress at the base level of the footing due to the weight of the soil from the ground surface to the base of the footing, calculated as unit weight of the soil multiplied by the depth of the footing. So 18 multiplied by 2. 18 is the unit weight of the soil, 2 is the depth of the footing. N sub Q equal to 26.12 multiplied by FQS equal to 1649 FQD. And FQD, which equal to 1 plus 0.269 multiplied by inverse tangent 2 divided by B multiplied by FQI, which is equal to 0.79, okay, plus gamma term 1 half multiplied by unit weight of soil 18, B unknown, and gamma is equal to 35.24 multiplied by F gamma S 0.6 multiplied by F gamma D equal to 1 multiplied by F gamma I equal to 0.486. So this ultimate bearing capacity equation equals to 1224.96 plus 329.51 inverse tangent 2 divided by B plus 92.48 B. So this is the expression for the ultimate bearing capacity in terms of B, right? Like in the previous steps, after ultimate bearing capacity, we calculate the allowable bearing capacity, okay? The allowable bearing capacity. So allowable bearing capacity, small q sub all equals to Q sub U divided by safety factor. Okay? So in this case, safety factor equals to 2, so 1 half. Okay? 1 over 2, 2 is the safety factor. So multiply by 1224.96 plus 329.51 inverse tangent 2 over B plus 92.48 B. Okay, this is the expression for pure label. So after divided by 2, then we obtain 612.48 plus 164.76 inverse tangent 2 divided by B plus 46.24 B. Okay, this is the final expression for the allowable bearing capacity. Q allowable equal to 612.48 plus 164.76 inverse tangent 2 over B plus 46.24 B. Okay, after determining the allowable bearing capacity, the next step is to determine the allowable load based on the allowable bearing capacity that we have calculated, and then we equate with the applied allowable load, which is 2000 kN. Right. So, allowable load Q allowable equals to allowable bearing capacity multiplied by the area of footing. In this case, Q allowable, the applied load, equal to 2000, right? And then the small Q allowable, or the allowable bearing capacity, which is equal to 612.48 plus 164.76 inverse tangent 2 over B plus 46.24 B. Right? This is the allowable bearing capacity. So we have to multiply by the area of footing, which is B squared. Okay, so this equation becomes 612.48 B squared plus 164.76 B squared inverse tangent 2 divided by B plus 46.24 B cubed. Okay. So, solve for B. So, use your calculator to obtain B. Right. You should get B equals to 1.55 meters. Okay. So, in the previous calculation, we found out that B equals to 1.5 meters, which is not correct with our assumption. But in this case, DF over B, which is equal to 2 meters, divided by B that we just obtained here, equals to 2 meters divided by 1.55 meters, yes, is greater than 1, so our assumption is correct. Okay. So that's how we solve the problem based on Meyerhoff-Hansen's equation. Right? So in normal practice, normally we are given the load from the structure, and then we have to design the foundation, whether it's in terms of the depth of the foundation or in terms of the dimension of the footing. Just like in our case, we are given the load, then we have to determine the dimension of the square footing. I hope everybody will follow the steps to solve the problem example. That's it for now, until we meet again. Thank you.